Hi everyone, my name is Meher from Vancouver, BC, and welcome to my YouTube channel. The purpose of my videos is to introduce you to tips that will help you elevate your job search by interviewing experts in the field. And if you are a first-time watcher, please subscribe to the channel so that you can get the notification every day I post a new video. So let's start with today's interview. Hi everyone, welcome back to another great interview series with me. Today, I have the privilege to interview George Khalife. Hi, George. How are you doing?
Doing well, brother. How are you?
Doing great. Thank you for being here. So, George is a sales and marketing professional with a background in finance and the DNA of an entrepreneur. He co-founded an app called Bookbag for students to buy and sell books more easily. And he also started a podcast called Let's Grab a Coffee, where he talks with very, very real cool leaders across different industries. So welcome, George, again. So for my first question for you is, tell me more about yourself, your career, and what challenges you had as an entrepreneur and starting your broadcast.
Yeah, so, well, thanks again for having me on. I know we were trying to set this up for quite some time, so yes. I'm glad we finally were able to do it. So a couple of things. I know we chatted before the podcast. We're both Lebanese, it turns out. So that's kind of how my story started. You know, I was born in Lebanon. And just like many immigrants who would probably listen to this, you know, I call it the immigrant roadshow, where I was born in Lebanon, grew up in Saudi Arabia. We then immigrated to Ottawa, went back to the Middle East, came back to Canada, recently moved to the US. So the story has always been about kind of shifting different countries. And mm-hmm. I think at a young age that probably helped me more than I realized to be, you know, obviously open to different cultures, but also I think improve on the ability to make new friends, you know, who maybe come from different cultures, ideologies, etc. So that was kind of key for me early on. I never had the opportunity to stay in one place for such a long time. So that was kind of the story from the personal side. When I moved to Canada, I was, you know, a chubby kid, pretty Arab, I would say. English was kind of my third language at the time when I was much, much younger. And it was a bit more difficult to assimilate kind of early on. But once I got the hang of it, it was kind of much smoother from there, I would say. And the one thing that helped me is I grew up in a family of bankers, you know, so my dad is a treasurer. His whole side of the family are heavily involved in banking. And so I thought that's always what I kind of looked up to, wanted to do. And so that's what I kind of enrolled in university, right? I started studying finance. And I think that was my tipping point, if you want to call it that. I was always this class clown. I didn't really give a crap in high school. I was always the guy who would make everyone laugh. Mm-hmm. And at some point in time, I had to kind of change my environment. And yes. Once I changed a couple of my friends, I started taking things more seriously, one being my career. And that's, I think, where things started snowballing. So I got involved in a lot of extracurricular activities, one of which was a student investment fund, led me to my first career with the Toronto Stock Exchange. And it just kind of spiraled from there. So the journey has been kind of interesting if you look at it from a personal lens, but very grateful for those different categories.
Okay, great. Thank you for sharing. And I'm sure in your broadcast, you had very cool people you interviewed. What can you share? You know, who was your greatest interviewer or what tips you can give us from that interviews? What was your, anything standing out?
Yeah, that's a good question, actually. I mean, so I started Let's Grab Coffee about almost 4 years ago now. Mm-hmm. I've had 64 episodes so far. I would say a lot of interesting guests, you know, kind of depends what you're looking for. I think for me, most of the people I'll have on now, especially is, you know, founders, CEOs, business leaders in different industries. I think some of my favorite ones were, I would say Mark Bowden. Mark is, you know, the top behavioral expert in Canada. So yes. He was consulting Stephen Harper at the time and he works with different leaders on nonverbal communication. Mm-hmm. I learned a lot from that episode. I would say Michael Hyatt, who's a celebrity on CBC Dragons then, he sold his business for about $500 million, not a bad amount.
Yeah.
Was able to learn a lot from him. And the last person I would say is David Siegel, who's the CEO and founder of David Stee. But I've had some amazing individuals, right? Claude Silver, who works at VaynerMedia, amazing person. I think you've had her. Yeah, you've had her on. So I think just having very different people. And also I think individuals not in business, right? I interviewed Dean Karzinas, who's an ultra marathon runner. And he ran 50 marathons, which is, by the way, 42 kilometers across 50 states in 50 days. So he would literally run a marathon every single day in different states. He's crazy. Wow. But what an incredible guy, right? So There's different lessons in each episode, and that's why I love doing these podcasts.
That's great. And I will put a link of your website so that people can watch. And for the people watching for the first time, my interview with George will be divided in around 5 days. So every day I'll ask a different question to George and it will be posted. And if you're a first time watcher, please subscribe to the channel and like and share the video and tune in tomorrow for another question with George.